Hey everybody. I thought I would do one more aquarium video. I was sitting here tonight just watching my fish. My iPad was close by, so I grabbed it and started taking these clips. Aquariums have a way of melting the stress from our lives. Well, sure, the stress will come back, but for a little while, you can feel relaxed and then just enjoy watching the little fish as they interact with each other and float around in their world of wonder. Studies have shown that gazing into an aquarium of fish actually will lower blood pressure. And that's good. It's good to de-stress. Stress can cause insomnia, make it hard to sleep. That little guy just sitting in that cave. Here's my platies. There's 4, not 8. That's the reflection of the glass. I wonder if they can see themselves. And if so, what must they think? If they're capable of thinking at all. Of my 4 platies, one of them is the mother, and the other 3 are what's left of her daughters. There's my Cory catfish, goofing around as usual. Corys seem to have a zest for life. They're very social and prefer to be in groups of at least 3 or more. And that's how many I have, is 3. Perhaps I'll add a couple of more sometime. That little guy is enjoying a little peace and solitude. but not for long before he joins his pal. As pleasurable as an aquarium is to look at, there is some work involved. If you currently do not have an aquarium and you're thinking about it, I have some advice. Do not get an aquarium unless you're physically able and willing to do the hard work of weekly partial water changes, because that is the key, that is the secret to fish keeping. Maybe some of you would disagree with what I just said, but I firmly believe that you must, on a weekly basis, remove part of the water that is in the tank and replace it with clean, fresh water that has been treated with a dechlorinizer to remove the chlorine. There's one of my autos. I have three of those little algae eaters. Now, on Wednesday, I call it Water Change Wednesday, I remove about 12 gallons and replace it with fresh, clean water. And I make sure that the water that I'm going to be dumping into the tank is the right temperature. If the temperature of the water in your tank is, say, 76 degrees, it's important that the water you're putting into your tank is about the same temperature. You don't want to throw your fish into shock by a drastic, sudden change in water temperature. You can actually kill them doing that. So if you've been thinking about an aquarium and you're willing to do the work and you're physically able to lift up a bucket of water high enough to pour into the tank, by all means, get an aquarium. They're great. But do your research first. Learn the importance of setting up your tank and letting it cycle without fish for 2 or 3 weeks or even a month. Have the discipline not to set up a tank and dump a bunch of fish into it. Go to the fish keeping websites and do your research, because there's a lot to learn. be picky about the fish that you put into your tank. A lot of people buy a wide variety of fish without taking into consideration that all of these different fish may not be capable of living in harmony in your tank. It's important to have harmony in your fish tank. So be careful about which fish you put in, and don't put too many fish in your tank. My tank is 29 gallons, and I have, I have 10 fish. Now, I can put a few more in if I wanted to, and everything would be fine. But there is a rule of thumb, and I think it is 2 inches of fish per gallon. So in my case, I could have about 15 fish, as long as they're fish of the sizes that I currently have, which are about 2 inches long. But like I said in my video, my time is limited, so there's a lot of other videos I'd like to make, and I will make, so this might be the last aquarium video for a while. And I hope you guys have enjoyed this series of aquarium videos. And I do appreciate you watching my channel. If you haven't subscribed, I invite you to. Thank you.